Module 7, we are going to discuss ordinary differential equations, the initial value problems. What I am going to do in the next few minutes is just give an overview of what we mean by ordinary differential equations and specifically what we mean by initial value problem, and then go through the outline of the things that we are going to cover in this particular module. So the background is, given that we have an equation, a differential equation of the type dy by dt equal to some function f of y and t. Keep in mind that this function f, in general we let it be a function of both the dependent variable y that we are interested in finding out and the independent variable t that varies and for which we are interested in finding the particular value of y. In addition to this particular differential equation, we also need to be given an initial condition. An initial condition would be of the form y at time t 0 is given as certain value y 0, and the objective of solving this ODE problem is to obtain y at any time t. So this is an example that I am showing graphically, where I have plotted the function y against the time t, and this is some arbitrary function y against t, okay. Let us consider any time ti. At that point ti, the slope of this curve is going to be the f of t. So the objective of the ODE solver is, given the function f of t, y comma t, that is the slope of the particular curve, we are interested in then finding out the entire curve as a function of y of t, okay. That is the overall background for this particular problem. This problem is, if you can see, is kind of related to the problem of integration. In some ways it is related to the problem of integration, in some other ways it is actually very different from the problem of integration. In case of integration, what we had is dy by dt as a function of t only. We did not have dy by dt as a function of y and t. Under that condition, we can have y equal to integral f of t dt, okay. And that is what we had done in the previous module, module 6. We had considered integration of a function f of t dt between the values a and b, and in that case, when we plot the function f of t against t, the integral signifies the area under this particular arbitrarily drawn curve, and the shaded area over here becomes the integral going from a to b f of t dt. Now, in case of an integration problem, the problem is a little bit different in the sense that we are now plotting, or we are interested in plotting or finding the function y of t given any function f, okay. So in that sense, this problem are different. In this case, we are interested in finding out this particular curve given the starting point y at some time t 0 equal to y 0. Whereas in the integration problem, we are interested in finding out this particular f of t curve, the area under that curve between the two limits of integration, okay. So that is the comparison with integration. Now let us take an example of a plug flow reactor. What we have done in the previous module was to determine the volume of the plug flow reactor that will give a certain conversion x. Okay, and in that particular case, we had plotted the function negative of 1 by Rx as a function of x. So what we did was, inverse of the rate of conversion, we plotted it as the y axis, and the conversion we plotted it as the x axis. The area under the curve multiplied by the inlet flow rate of the reactant A in terms of moles per unit time. That product actually gave us the volume of the CSTR, okay. Now this particular design equation, the volume of a PFR, this particular design equation of a PFR is obtained from this overall model of the PFR, where the model is initially written based on the mass balance, and based on the mass balance we will get a model of this form, and then expressing the concentration in terms of conversion variables, we'll be able to convert that particular model in this form, Okay, so what we are going to do in case of an ODE solving is we are going to solve this particular equation given that the volume, given that the conversion at 0 volume at or conversion at the starting of the reactor is 0. Okay, so with that condition we are going to start our ODE solver. Okay, so there are some parallels between integration and solving of the ODE, but in general ODE solutions for chemical engineering problems or in general for engineering problems go well beyond the limits limitations of an integration method of solving. Okay, now let me motivate the means that we are going to use in order to solve numerically the ODE subject to the initial conditions. We are given the ODE dy by dt equal to f of y comma t. Let us say at the current instant, let us say the current instant is given by t equal to ti, and at ti we know all the value yi, ti and everything else that we need to know about the system. Okay. So now dy by dt is nothing but limit as delta t tends to 0 yi plus 1 minus yi divided by delta t. Now that is going to be equal to f of yi comma ti. Okay. When we write this particular expression and let delta t be very small, in that particular case what we will get this as the solution is a means of numerically solving the ODE. Okay. And that particular, by a simple rearrangement of this particular equation, what we will get is yi plus 1 equal to yi plus delta t multiplied by f of yi comma ti. Now what I have done over here is replaced f of yi comma ti with another function s of yi comma ti. Recall, based on our geometric discussion, s is nothing but the slope of the curve y against t. Okay, so we will go back a couple of slides earlier. Okay, this at a point ti, s is nothing but the slope. Now that slope can be computed at the point yi comma ti, or it can be computed using the various different means, and the means that we are going to use in order to compute this particular slope is going to give us different methods of solving the ODE problem. Some methods are going to be more accurate than certain other methods. Some other methods have certain stability properties of interest to us. All these are something that we are going to consider in this particular module. Okay. So the numerical methods are going to focus on using appropriate means to obtain the slope s in order to improve the accuracy of the solution y that we get as a function of time t. Okay. So that is what we are going to use, that is how rather we are going to use a numerical method to obtain the ODE solution. Okay. So we start with certain value y0 and we use a certain small enough delta t, and we keep using the numerical method recursively in order to get y at t1, t2, t3, t4 and for the entire range of t of our interest. Okay. That is the recursive method of solving an ODE. It is a recursive numerical method for solving the ODE, and we will actually be able to get y at discrete times t0, t1, t2, t3, t4 and so on. Okay. Now we can choose our delta t either to be a constant value, or we can change the value of delta t depending on how the slope s changes. If the slope s is very steep, we will take small delta t values, or if the slope s is not very steep, we can perhaps take larger delta t values. That is the basis behind what is known as adaptive step size. Delta t is the step size of the independent variable, and this step size is something for us to choose, and we will see how the choice of step sizes is going to affect the overall quality of the solution, how to choose this particular step size, how the accuracy of the solution depends on the various numerical methods, so on and so forth, are something that what we are going to cover in this particular module. The next important question that we are going to cover in this module is the question of explicit versus implicit method. In the previous slide, we'll go back to the previous slide. What we had done is the differential dy by dt, we had represented it as yi plus 1 minus yi divided by delta t. The other way to represent this particular differential is also to represent it as yi minus yi minus 1 divided by delta t, okay. And these two different methods are going to lead us to different ways of solving this this particular problem. This method that I have shown over here is what is known as an implicit method, whereas if we had represented dy by dt as yi minus yi minus 1 divided by delta t, that would be what is known as an implicit method, okay. Now we can just rearrange the implicit method in a little bit different way, and those ways I have shown it over here. This is the explicit method that we have talked about, and this is the implicit method. Let us go to the explicit method first. Yi plus 1 is yi plus delta t multiplied by the slope. The slope depends explicitly on yi and ti. Yi and ti are quantities that are already known at the time ti, okay. So yi plus 1 is computed directly from known quantities, from already known quantities. So this particular equation is not used as an algebraic equation, but instead it is used as an expression. That means we solve the right hand side, whatever value we get at the right hand side, we just use that value as yi plus 1 and keep proceeding into the future. That is the explicit method. The implicit method, with slight rearrangement, we can write implicit method as yi plus 1 equal to yi plus delta t multiplied by the slope computed based on yi plus 1. So what is happening over here is at time I, the value yi plus 1 is not yet known. So the slope yi plus 1 is computed at a point which is currently not known. So it depends implicitly on the unknown quantities, okay. So yi plus 1 then can be computed using the above nonlinear equation. So in this particular case, this particular form of equation is used as an explicit expression. That means we calculate the right hand side and just assign it to yi plus 1, whereas this is used as an algebraic equation which we can perhaps solve using techniques such as Newton-Raphson's techniques or fixed point iteration techniques, so on and so forth. So yi plus 1 implicitly depends on itself, yi plus 1, okay. That is the implicit method of solving the equation, okay. And we are going to cover implicit methods and explicit method and what it means from the stability viewpoint of any algebraic equation solver. These are the things that we are going to cover in this particular module. So finally, to give an overview of this particular module, we will cover what is known as the Euler's methods. Euler's methods are the implicit and the explicit methods that we just spoke about couple of slides earlier. Those are actually known as the Euler's methods. Then we will in general talk about implicit methods versus explicit methods. What do implicit versus explicit actually means. Then we will talk about the Runge-Kutta family of methods. We will look at the error analysis as usual. We'll talk about how the error propagates as the I changes as we go from y0 to y1, y1 to y2, y2 to y3, so on and so forth. How is our numerical solution going to compare with our analytical solution? We'll also talk about stability, which basically means that given y0, when we are going to compute y1, y2, y3, y4, so on and so forth, as I tends to infinity, does our the solution, does our numerical solution remain stable, or does the numerical solution go to plus or minus infinity? That is the problem that we are going to tackle with respect to the stability of these methods. Okay. So all these become one class of methods where we are going to use some means in order to compute the slope s. Then another class of methods are what is known as predictor corrector methods. In predictor corrector methods, what we are going to do is we are going to use a method to compute the slope s, that is called a predictor method, and then we are going to use certain set of equations known as corrector equations in order to improve the accuracy of the approximation. What that means is that there will be an equation written in this particular form which will be a predictor equation that will help us to compute yi plus 1. Now we have the value of yi and an approximate solution of yi plus 1, recursively the value yi and the approximate solution yi plus 1 will be used to correct the value of yi plus 1 in order to get a higher order accurate formula. Okay. The next set of methods is known as the Adam-Multons family of methods. And finally, we will cover two slightly advanced topics in this particular module. First is the adaptive step sizing. I had mentioned a couple of slides earlier that this delta t need not be constant. The value of delta t we can change based on how the value of slope changes in order to get higher order accuracy formulae. Okay. So, we will try to talk about how to change the step size adaptively based on the current solution of the ODE that we are trying to solve. And finally, we will come to what is known as stiff ODEs. I will motivate what we mean by stiff ODEs and look at the solvers that solve the stiff ODE problems.